We're here at Horticulture Park, where we will show you some simple ways to collect insects. First, let's review some common collecting items that we'll use in this video. There's nets, sometimes called butterfly nets, to catch winged insects. Beet sheets, these are good for collecting insects in trees and bushes. If you can find one, an aspirator is good to have to collect tiny insects. Some other items that are helpful are white collecting trays and vials to store the insects you find. Okay, let's start what we call active collecting techniques. This just means you are the one catching the insects instead of, say, using a trap. The easiest technique is to simply inspect logs on the ground. Roll the logs over or lift up the bark and see what's inside. Depending on where you are and the time of year, some insects you may find with this technique are beetles, true bugs, and a lot of insect larvae. If it's safe, you can pick up some insects you find with your hands. Make sure you know which insects are safe to handle. And be gentle, you don't want to crush them. Don't forget to roll the logs back the way you found them. We don't want to disturb the established microhabitat. There may be times when the log is so old, you can break off chunks to find insects inside. Here we have downed trees killed by emerald ash borer larvae, an invasive beetle. Just crumble up the chunks over the white trays and find the insects inside. If there is any fungus growing on the log, check inside. Insects like beetles or flies can be found. As you see here, we use a small hatchet to break off bits of the fungus into our white tray and then inspect the tray. For flying insects, you'll want to use a net. Winged insects are fast, so you'll need to give a good swing of the net to capture them. At the end of the swing, give a little flick of the net, twisting it to trap the insect, or else it will just fly right out. To remove a winged insect that stings, like bees or wasps, you don't want to touch them with your hands. As you can see here, you will twist up the end of the net and use a vial to carefully transfer the insect. Even if it doesn't bite, this is a good technique since grabbing wings with your hands can damage them. And if you're making a pinned collection, you want to keep the wings intact. Another way we collect insects is using a beet sheet. This is good for collecting insects in trees and bushes. Place the sheet underneath some branches like you see here, and then literally just beat the branches with a pole. The insects and other debris will fall down onto the sheet. Inspect your sheet. For tiny insects, an aspirator is useful. Literally suck up the insect into the jar. Don't worry, the insect won't go into your mouth. If you're collecting in an area where you know no one will disturb it, like your backyard, leaving an insect trap is another technique you can use. Here's an easy insect trap you can make. Put some water in a brightly colored bowl. Add a few drops of dish soap to break the surface tension of the water so that insects fall in. Yellow bowls generally appear to work best. The bright color mimics flower petals and will attract pollinating insects like bees. Another trap you can make is a pitfall trap. Dig a hole and place a cup inside. Bury the cup lightly with dirt, making sure the rim is flush with the ground around it. Walking insects will then fall into the cup. Trapping takes patience, but can be a passive way to collect insects over a period of time. So those are just some of the ways to collect insects. We hope you enjoyed this video. Happy hunting!